What's up, guys? I am back with another video. And yes, we're doing a pajama tarot reading. Come on out. So, let me take this one. My scroll off so we can get comfortable. Make sure y'all get comfortable. Go put y'all pajamas on. Get ready. Get into this reading. Get comfortable. Get you a snack. Because we're about to get into this. Let's burn some sage. Let's turn this off. Come on out. Hope everybody is ready. And welcome to the pajama party. Join me. Get your pajamas on. Get your food. Burn your sage. And let's get into this. It always took me forever to burn the sage. Why? I don't know. And I also had to burn you guys a chakra. So I already wrote the astrology, guys. So we will be doing Virgo, Capricorn, and Scorpio. I want to start off with Virgo first. I'm feeling Virgo. Okay, I hope this thing stay burnt. Do y'all think I be overburning that thing? But it don't even be lighting. Why is it lighting like that? What the world? I guess. Whoa. Jesus. See that flame? Could be dealing with a fire sign. Sagittarius, Leo. Or Aries, Virgo. So yeah, we're gonna do Virgo first. Wait till this go out. I didn't wanna put it on a thing with that big old flame. Start a fire. All right, let's get into the video. Gonna get one more chakra. So we're gonna burn for Virgo. We're gonna burn the heart chakra. The heart chakra increases your ability to feel love, kindness, and affection. When open, you will be more compassionate, friendly, and you will strive for more harmonious relationships. Okay, Virgo. Let's get into this. Light that up. Do not light my flowers. Come on, what are you doing? Mm-mm, we're too close to my flowers. I might have to put this plate over to the side so that way the ashes don't be all messing up the table. Oh, excuse me. I hope everybody had a wonderful day today. I really do. My day was pretty peaceful. It was pretty cool. Very calm, cool, and collected. I made a couple of videos earlier that I already uploaded. Go check those videos out if you would like to. So, let's get into this. Let me put this in my laptop. Okay. Okay. I've already shuffled the deck and prayed over the deck before and saged the deck too before I started the reading. I just didn't. I just want to shuffle again. I just didn't pull out no spreads because I like to do the spreads on camera. So, again, guys, this reading is for the sign of Virgo. Okay, King of Wands came out. Virgo. Real strong man. I'm picking up man energy for Virgo. Picking up man energy. Standing in your power about something. You've been through a lot of things, but it's in your past. It's not happening right now. Been through a lot and you earned your rewards. That's why you're sitting as a king. You know, you're like, I know better. Judgment call wanted to come out. Don't forget to like this video, comment, and subscribe down below, please. Hit that subscribe button or I'm gonna stop. It's like, I ain't gonna stop. I can't stop. Oh man, my car keep getting bent up. Okay, keep going. I don't like pulling out regular spreads. I kind of let my spirit angels, spirit guides speak to me through slippers, which are cards that automatically flip out. I don't like to force an opinion on someone's reading because it is general. So take this reading how it resonates. This is not a personal reading. And if you do want a personal reading, don't forget to comment down below. And I can tell you more details on how you can get a personal reading with me. Okay. Okay. Come on, spirit angels, spirit guys. Let's go. This is a lot of shuffling now. Come on. Come on. Come on. There we go. Oh, exactly. Wow. Ooh, the world card, but it was in reverse. Okay. You could be feeling stabbed in the back by somebody you gave the world to. And I was picking up before. Could be dealing with a Sagittarius. This is a Sagittarius card. You could be feeling stabbed in the back for giving this person the world. Knight of Swords here. This is a guy. I'm speaking in reference to a guy. This is definitely a man. Man energy. You have the King of Wands and the Knight of Swords. Ooh, I felt the heat. You feel the stab in the back about something. You rushing in with some tacky communication in regards to the way you feel about whatever this person did to you. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You worried about all you invested. You was working very hard on this investment with this person. You invested a lot of time. Like 8 years with this person. Okay. You gave this person the world. Whoever this person is, you really loved them. You truly did love them, but it's only but so much love and a person can do when you don't appreciate how much love I'm giving to you. It doesn't work like that. And you have to love yourself first, which you are definitely standing in your power as the King of Wands. And as you should, as a king, Virgo. Don't be allowing nobody to use you and abuse you and walk all over you. And, you know, you, exactly, walking away. You have the Eight of Cups, like I said, you definitely the Emperor. Oh yeah, you gonna stand in your power. Like I said, this is man energy, definitely myself, and you're definitely gonna walk away. The investments that you invested in something, you work really hard on it. You gonna say, you know what? Forget what I invested in. I'm just gonna go ahead and leave. You gonna leave them, even with the house, maybe the house, maybe the cars. Let's get some more cards. Let's get some animal spirit oracle cards. Yeah, you're not having it. Like, you're over it. You can't do it. You really thought this person was your number one. You really was being yourself, and they just took advantage of you. Time for a deep dive. Okay. Time for a deep dive. Okay. Time to collaborate. I don't think you want to talk to this person, collaborate, do anything. If anything, you want to collaborate on a divorce because you didn't invest so much time and energy into this person. Could be It said, take a leap of faith, time to collaborate. Okay, so maybe you're about to meet someone new. We're gonna find out. You could be the age of 30. Let's take them. They came out, so I normally like to take one, but these cards are so thick. It says, believe in yourself. Use your mind wisely. Surrender now. Trust in the magic. Tend to the small things. Maybe, maybe you're about to meet someone, Virgo. And you're going to need to really use your mind wisely in regards to the situation just because you're coming out of another situation. But you also need to pay attention to the small details in regards to this person. Excuse me. Surrender now. Maybe you need to pray on the situation, and you definitely need to believe in yourself because Virgos are very much so strong people. Very much so go-getters. Very strong people. Even though you were stabbed in the back, you still got it. Like, I think don't allow that situation to determine, make you sad, make you depressed, make you feel like, you know, you don't have hope for love. You have to know that sometimes you go through things with people so you can end up in a better situation. Like, sometimes people do things. Sometimes people hang themselves and do things. Time to heal. Which you are definitely going to heal from the situation. Let's get some more cards. Because this is really, like, all over the place. Like, let's get some more cards for her. Get some raw deck of cards. Somebody could be very much so in denial about something, and it's causing you. Could be dealing with a Cancer. Could be dealing with a water sign, but honestly, I do see water in here. Oh, yeah. I should have mentioned that. Yeah, it's definitely water in this reading. You're going to have to be strong, Virgo, and have faith in the situation. Whatever this situation is, whatever this person did to you, it's going to cause you to have courage. And I think maybe you have children by this person. See? The kids card wanted to come out. Oops, sorry. I think you may have children by this person. And you could be going into an awakening with knowing the truth or finding out the truth and really feeling stabbed in the back. And you want to take action in regards to it. Talk to your mom, your grandma, your friends, somebody who, yeah, see, the awakening card came out. It definitely must so hit to with what's going on. And it could be somebody that you married to. And at this point, it's okay to cry. And sickness wanted to come out. I hope this situation is not making you sick. Because you also got the time to heal card. I hope nobody, somebody's in denial about something. It's very much so. Stress. Yeah. You're going to have to take it easy. That's why they say tend to the small things. Like, you know, go take a walk. You know, go get some ice cream. I know it's kind of cold outside, but you can go in the house and eat ice cream. But ice cream makes me feel better. So.
hopefully make you feel better. I don't know. But whatever this person did, yeah, it's definitely a love situation. Whatever this person did, it stabbed you in the back and it got you feeling very effed up. You're about to make a move, which also... clarifies this card right here. Like, you're leaving. You're definitely gonna take a leap of faith, time for a deep dive. You're definitely gonna walk away from this situation. Most definitely. As you should, because this person did something, and I'm not sure they stole money from you. I'm not sure they cheated on you with your friend. I'm not sure if they lied on you. I'm not, because it's not being really specific, but they are telling me that. Okay, they say give you more. Okay, I'll give you more. Well, maybe you wanted more in the situation, but Spirit is telling me keep going, give you more. Give you more. Pisces. A lot of water signs. Change is coming, though. Definitely. Could have been dealing with a water sign for years. For years. This is not somebody you just met. This is somebody you've been dealing with. The father card came out. Maybe you're the father of the child. Or maybe you found out you're not the father of someone else's child. Remember I told you this was very much so man energy. Just, I'm not picking up any female energy at all. Maybe you found out that you're not the father, and it's, you really feel messed up about this situation because you really thought that, look, the Virgo card wanted to come out, but like I said, I'm only taking cards that fly out because that's just how I do it. I'm not sure if your grandmother passed away or not, Virgo, but she's with you and you need to continue to pray. She's definitely with you. That'll help you with at least creating some type of balance. You've been dealing with this for years. Like, you invested years in this. You thought you was the dad for years. I'm really picking up. I'm faithful wanted to come out. I'm really definitely picking up. Somebody thought they was the father. And take it how it resonates, guys. Don't forget this is a general reading. So if this is not your reading, don't be negative. You know, but if it is, please let me know because this is bad. Like, you really feel sick. Like, sickness keep wanting to come out. Like, this situation causing you a great amount of stress. And don't stress too bad because, I can't even say don't stress too bad because if you invested time into somebody and you really thought that this child was your child, like your baby, I want to pull... Like, this person was your world. Like, I want to pull some more, but they said give you more. I want to pull some more, tarot cards. Look, the Virgo card keep wanting to jump out, y'all. Wow. You were very nurturing, and this person was not playing by the rules at all, not one bit. Could have been dealing with a Libra. This, whatever this was very sensual, and you needed to slow down. Silence. Right now, you could be keeping to yourself. Ooh, this Virgo keep jump out, y'all. Wow, like I keep seeing, like, yeah, your grandmother could be a Leo, and she's definitely not. Ooh, this Virgo keep jumping out. She's definitely trying to connect with you. 222. I'm seeing 222. Somebody was definitely being unfaithful. Blow the horn. You could be moving out of the home, Virgo, because you're just not in it. Yo, this keeps coming to the forefront, like, and I keep shuffling.
okay to cry. If you need to, it's okay to cry. I feel bad, like, damn, Virgo. Yeah, you're definitely gonna be moving. Have courage, life changes, victory, emergency, now. You're definitely gonna be moving, getting a new apartment or a new house or something. I'm definitely picking up on that. You just getting away from that, bad energy. Like, it's something you can't. Let's get some regular cards. That's how the shuffling is, damn thing. I feel like I spend more time shuffling than I do trying to get the message out, because it's not coming out. Yeah. The Tower card in judgment. Could be taking this person to court in regards to what they did. And it's definitely in regards to children. Wow. The Tower card. So, something definitely happened, Virgo. And everything came crashing down in regards to the situation. Something you're really thinking about. Yeah, you're trying to. You wanted to balance this situation out. Like, you thought, you know, if you give this person exactly what they want, everything that they ask for, that they would, you know, give you loyalty in return and what you asked for. But it wasn't an equal give and take. It wasn't. And it's not on your end, it's on their end. Something about the sun. The sun card wanted to come out. Yeah, this was somebody you was married to. This was a marriage. This was somebody you plan on spending the rest of your life with, but due to falseness and lying, you walking away. You ain't got time for that. Especially trying to balance out. How are we gonna balance out you having a child with somebody else? How are we gonna do that when I thought this was my baby? Now I don't even look at the baby the same. You know, like, what the? That's weird. I don't understand how people fuck up and then they want you to balance out the fuck up. Like, why would you do what you did in the first place? And now you want me to balance it out so we can work. But had you been working on us, we wouldn't be here. So I don't get it. That sounds like a narcissist. This is definitely something that happened to a guy. You thought this was your queen. You definitely did. And no shade, she still is a queen. People make mistakes, but you definitely gonna be picking up, walking away from this situation. Let's get some ball decks. Get some vice cards. Whoa. This person could have definitely had a slip up. She's still a queen, though. Like, people make mistakes. I ain't gonna badmouth this lady. Queen cocky wanna come out, but you can't deal with her. Yeah, it wasn't equal give and take. Not at all. Something could have happened in July. This could have happened in July. Third party. Giving it three people. Yeah, Three of Pentacles. Seven, yep. Dang. This happened 7 years ago because I think the child is like around 8 or something. Look what came out. Wow. This happening, y'all? Yeah, somebody was playing you for a joke, taking you as a joker, and the joke is on them, because one thing about it, you don't play with that third party. Definitely Three of Pentacles. Somebody put you in a third party situation, and you're a king. Like, you don't have time to be playing with no damn other people, especially if you wanted to actually deal with this one person. Oh Jesus, I gotta go down there and get that. You gave this person a Ten of Cups. Hold on, I gotta go get that card that fell. Ooh, my booty sticking to the chin. Gotta go all the way down.
Yeah, this is definitely what she did to you. Played a joke on you. Whoever this queen is, she definitely played a joke on you. Let's get some animal spirit card. Spirit guide, spirit angels, please send me any messages that you need this man to know. This is a Virgo guy. He needs to know what at least what should he do next? Did it flip? Because if it did, I'll take it. I wanna advise you. I feel bad for you. Like, what should you do next in this situation after this person did this to you? Like, what in the world? Clear the clutter. Get out of there. Like, clear the air. You know what? I can't deal with this. Which I wouldn't deal with somebody doing that either. Like, I would leave automatically. Not saying that, like, leave the kids, but be honest about how you feel. You know, daggone well, you can't deal with this person, and it's going to be a struggle for you to continue to deal with this person after what they did to you. Be honest with this person. They'll be dealing with a Capricorn, because this person was definitely messed up, unfaithful. You admired them for the way, I guess, you thought that they loved and whatever you thought y'all had, but the truth always comes out later. You gotta be strong. Definitely be strong. I told you was gonna be moving, and the unfaithful card wanted to come out as well. You have the new house card. I told you, you're going to be moving. Clear out the clutter. You definitely going to get a new house. And you're going to be moving away from this person. Definitely. Because they were very much so unsafe to you. Really picking up Sagittarius energy. And they keep going to come out too. Unfaithful again. Third party later. Remember I said the truth always comes out later. Third party betrayal. You're going to be single. You may struggle a little bit. You have 777 help. Third party again. 666 and less. Nevertheless, no stress. That's what you need to be worried about. I am going to look up these synchronicities that we have. New job wanted to come out. I am going to look up these synchronicities that we, this person is definitely very much someone faithful to you. Parents. Yeah, this is somebody who you had a child by. This is definitely somebody who you shared the Virgo card again. I wonder about. Scorpio, I said Scorpio, so it's about the water signs. It says embrace balance. So, I guess you got to take this person to court, so you're going to have to balance out the divorce. Because you guys are married, and it's going to be a big change in regards to that. You have a new job, and I give up. Don't quit your job, Virgo. Don't quit your job. Maybe, look what came out. Doop, doop. Let's get a song for that, because that's why I kept shuffling for y'all. I told you. I told y'all. Let's see if we come on. And this is the song that's coming on. Virgo. Says, I give up. Embrace balance. Somebody was unfaithful. Scorpio, Pisces, or Cancer. I'm gonna really do these cards over. I'm gonna keep the same. Y'all go ahead and listen to that. I'm gonna talk in a minute. So I need to clean this up a little bit. A little messy. Stay strong.
Let me get this come up. So, with that being said, I'm definitely going to close out this reading because it confirms, spirit definitely confirmed that this is for Virgo. Came out. It surely did. And it kept wanting to come out. Like, it kept jumping at me. But, like I told y'all, I don't like to pull the cards out. I prefer to connect with my ancestors and my spirit guides. I would like for them to tell me versus me trying to, yeah. This lady, you was really in love with this. Leave her. She ain't no good. She don't mean you no good. I'm not going to say she no good because I don't know her. But this person don't mean you no well, and this situation broke your heart. You've been with this person for a long time. You very much so invested in this situation. And you heartbroken because you thought this person really was your world. You gave them your world. You allowed them to come into your world. This is really, sorry ladies. Virgo ladies, but this reading is for a guy, specifically somebody out there. Please comment down below and let me know if this resonates with you, because I will help you through this situation. Like, I don't condone making people think that. Why would they do that? Like, why would she do that to you? Like, you gotta be strong, though. And it says, I give up. You should give up on her. And when you give up on her, look, you got a new job. You had a new house. Oh, I got to give y'all read your synchronicities for you. It say help. Maybe they're going to be trying to expect for you to keep paying bills and doing this and doing that. You don't need to help them no more. Nevertheless, no stress. You got 666, third party. And not only did you get third party, you got it twice. 3 times 3 is 6, and you got 6, 6, and you got 3, 3. Y'all, okay. Scorpio, Virgo, to confirm, like, this is just, it say blow the horn, like, get this lady out of here, get out of your way. 777. Yeah, you definitely gonna leave. You have a new house. Silence. And like I said, I feel like this has something to do with you being the father of a child that ain't yours. It's that you're about to make a move and you're stressed out about it. Because it's like, you done created a bond with this baby probably. And bought stuff for the baby. And all types of things that people do when you have children. That's yours. Okay. So, I am going to give you your synchronicity meanings, Virgo. Give me 1 second while I clean up this mess that this person done put you in. Because this is a mess. It ain't. But honestly, you should take this as in a positive way, because if you didn't find this out, you would have kept on moving your life forward with this person, kept on investing in this situation. New house came. Look, you leaving. Get out of there. So, okay. Can y'all hear my boyfriend in there? So, let's see. I am going to start memorizing the synchronicities and writing them down so I don't have to, not saying waste more time, but, you know, for some people who are, like, are very impatient, I'm going to try my best to try to have them mentally on mine, and you know, even on the cards. So I do, these cards were like hit at a moment when I made them, so I am going to try my best to refix them and make them more professional. Okay. 333 symbolizes aid and encouragement, just like the angel number 1313. It means that your angels are just nearby, ready to help and reassure you that your plans are going well. The angel number 333, as well as angel number 614,
also carries the energy of joy and inspiration. So you actually happy to lead this situation, and that, you know, take that how it resonates. Like I said, it's not a personal reading, so I can't get too personal. All right, let's see. When we honestly ask ourselves which person in our lives, this is for 666, okay? It's not always a devil number. It depends on a person's mental capacity. When we honestly ask ourselves which person in our lives means the most to us, we often find that it is those who, instead of giving advice, solution, or cures, have chosen rather to share our pain and touch our wounds with a warm and tender hand. Take that how it resonates, Virgo. 777. What the world? Okay. Seven, seven, seven means release your fears, let go of control, and find your inner strength. And you also have the Be Strong card. So you definitely going to move forward from this. And I definitely hope you do, Virgo. This is your reading. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'm very sorry that this happened to you. If you need my advice or help with any further personal readings or readings, period, comment down below and let me know if this resonated with you. Don't forget, guys, this is definitely a general reading, so don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching.